born in a little town in Thuringen in Germany.
I was born in Budapest,
Hungary in 1938.
Lithuania.
Santiago de Cuba in Cuba.
In Da Nang, Vietnam.
Vietnam.
In Ethiopia.
In the south of Sudan.
The most vivid memory is just the fear. Fear of everything.
The fear of being either in prison, fear of being killed.
When it got dark, I'm always afraid.
We were Jews. My father had a store in the middle of town. 3 years after I was born, Hitler came to power. Every other month, a new rule came down until finally in 1938, we were arrested and shipped off and dumped on the border of Poland.
Unfortunately, I remember very well. My father was taken away when I was 4 years old, and I never saw him again. It was a very, very fearful time.
We were one of the states that was ceded to the Russians. I demonstrated like all the other students.
I was at the university where the revolution started.
It didn't last very long.
It took us 4 days and four nights to get through the border. It was mined some places. There were electrified fences.
My parents and I escaped in 1944. I was 18 months old. My father was very active in the anti-communist underground. So when the Soviets came, he knew he was either going to be imprisoned, murdered, or expelled to Siberia.
We took one of the last ferry boats that came out of Cuba. Now at the time, we thought we were going away for the summer.
I remember the date, July 18, 1960, and we left around noon, and the boat trip lasted about 6.5 hours. My big brother was 12, and at that point in time, the Castro movement began to conscript boys of that age into the militia.
I can only appreciate now that I'm a father, just leaving everything you have behind because you fear for the well-being of your kids.
We left a lot of people behind, both family and friends.
And every day, my mom said, you know, make sure you hug your father because you don't know if they're gonna come take him away tonight. After a while, we caught on that they were planning on an escape. Literally in the middle of the night, one night, we left and we say goodbye to my 77-year-old grandmother, who had no one to take care of her. And I know if you talk to my father, that's probably the saddest thing for him. But he said, you know, his children was more important to him, for us to have a future and someone would take care of his mother.
So this military junta overthrew the government. They were actually killing people. A lot of young kids died during that time. Next safest country was Sudan. When I went to Sudan, there were probably two or three well-established refugee camps. Thousands of people were living there.
And every time you see the plane, you pack up whatever, even if you were cooking. So every day we did that. And after, like, I think it was like the fifth or sixth time, I just looked at my mom. And I realized if there's less and less of us, we're more likely to get in the plane. I had to get into the plane on my own, pretending I was my neighbor's daughter. And it hurt me because I didn't want to leave my mom, but this was the only way.
The captain said, throw your belongings overboard. Throw everything away. Throw away your old clothes, your old suitcases. You're in America now. You will have plenty of everything. I even threw my doll overboard because my mother said, oh, this is America. You can get lots of dolls.
We felt very, very welcome. The sense of strangers opening their arms to you.
They took us to an apartment that a staff member like the IRC has rented for us. They had taken donations for food, clothing, furniture, televisions, everything.
The IRC wasn't the only agency I went to. I talked to everybody I could. The IRC took me.
A piece of me was never stopped being a refugee.
That's probably true with all of us.
Oh, absolutely.
Very much so.
You empathize with what maybe they went through.
What you yourself went through.
And so for the following waves and generations that, you know, came afterwards.
Their experiences may have been different, but.
That could have been me. That could have been my family.
These are strong people, amazing people that have endured so much.
They would work and take any job they can to make sure that their children become Americans and become successful Americans.
The foundation of this country is a refugee story. It is ordinary people, people who are hungry, who have been persecuted, coming to this country and living the dream of the country.
I was a Jew in Hungary who thought he was a Hungarian, but who was made clear that I was not. I came to a country, I barely spoke its language, and I was taken as an American. So that's what I am.